is coming out on the ice. His hometown is Paris. It is Nicolas Petorin. And here he is, and the crowd is ready for him. They call him here the French Scott Hamilton.
Can't be a better feeling than being in front of your home crowd at the Olympic Games. This is tough. Triple axel. Oh. Problem on that. There was supposed to be a triple toe loop. So that is a omission.
The French are having a bad night. Eric Milo, their champion, also had a couple of tumbles.
If this doesn't get him going, nothing will. Crowd behind him like this. And it seemed to help. Line sequence. And a missed double axel, unfortunately. He was supposed to rotate 2.5 times around in the air, and he only completed one rotation.
Get good marks for his French followers, but he is in his first Olympics and he is in his home country. Youngster won't be 20 years old until late this summer. As always, the ice hall, the Hall de Glace, is absolutely packed.
Here's the triple axel. Now, he falls down. Interestingly enough, Kurt Browning did the same thing. He doesn't even complete the triple toe loop that was after it, or double toe for that. But the triple Lutz, I think the crowd really helped him here, and he pulled that one off beautifully.
Let me run some big names by you as we take a look and wait for the scores. Kurt Browning, the world champion the last 3 years, fell, did not complete his prescribed schedule that he had set up. Christopher Bowman had to hit the triple, fell. Todd Eldridge, back from the back problem, doing very well to the end, and fell. All three big names fell. So at the top, Viktor Petrenko, who was nearly flawless from Odessa, Russia. Peter Barna of Czechoslovakia with a lot of ballet in his movements. And Paul Wiley, the Harvard graduate, who was nearly flawless. So they're 1, 2, 3 at the moment.
And most of the falls, interestingly enough, were on that combination that we were talking about.
How realistic is it, Peter, as we take a look for these marks, looking, let's go down through, say, number 4, Christopher Browning, that Browning can, or Curtis Browning, can bring himself up from 4 to 1 with a Petrenko who seldom makes the big mistake.
It would be very difficult at this point because Petrenko would have to place lower than third to have Browning pull up over him, or possibly second.
Can you imagine the impact in Canada, where he is their biggest sportsman of any year? And now let's take a look at these marks for this Frenchman, and they won't like it, of course, for Nicolas Petorin. Unified team, 4-8. USA, 4-4. Czechoslovakia, 4-3. And Canada marked him down along with Australia at 4-2.
First of all, 4-2, 4-6, 4-8. 4-7.
Now, what do they think of him artistically for his presentation?
And they seem to be better, and his artistic impression was better. With those mistakes in the triple axel combination, the judges, again, cannot ignore that, and they must make
31 scheduled tonight to skate. One withdrew, so we're down to 30, and this is the 29th. The next to last is a Xuben Zhang of the People's Republic of China. He's 25 years old.